All the horses are approaching the starting gates. Just 1 minute till post time. They'll be loading shortly. Just a reminder, live racing resumes here next Monday as we are finished on Sunday afternoon racing until next year. The remainder of our race schedule will be live racing every Monday right through until October 21st. First race post time, our usual 12:55. Next week's feature races will be the Peacock Derby Trials. The horses are now entering the starting gates. First one in, number one, Express Your Desire. Number three, Feisty Icon. Number six is in, Night Fishing. Number seven goes in, Albert, trying to give Scott Reed and Cassandra Jeske their third win of the afternoon. Number four is Sugarman's Delight. Five is Sweet Pagrana, one of two in the field for Hestie Sport Incorporated. Number eight, A Rising Miracle. Number nine, Had to Be Ivory is in. The last one in will be number five, Sweet Pagrana. They're at the post. And they're off in the Ontario Bred Maturity. Sweet Pagrana broke well in the center. From the extreme outside is Had to Be Ivory and Night Fishing and Albert. It's Had to Be Ivory on the outside, already in the lead. Second is Sweet Pagrana. Towards the fence there is Feisty Icon. But this one's as good as over. Had to Be Ivory destroys the field in the Ontario Bred Maturity. We're going to have a place photo. The unofficial winner of the Ontario Bred Maturity is number 9, Had to Be Ivory. Finishing second was number 8, A Rising Miracle. In the show photo was number 3, Feisty Icon, third, and fourth number 5, Sweet Pagrana. The results of the sixth race are now official. The winner of the Ontario Bred Maturity is number 9, Had to Be Ivory. 4-year-old Bay Gelding by Ivory James out of Had to Be Fandango by Had to Be Nuts. Bred and owned by the partnership of Carol and Jamie Robertson, Had to Be Ivory is trained by Bryn Robertson and ridden to victory by jockey Tony Phillips. Had to Be Ivory winning the distance, a new track record here at Ajax Downs, 19.60 seconds, carrying a 108 speed index, eclipsing the record of 2018 champion Country Boy 123 by 4/100ths of a second, previously at 19.64. Once again, the new track record with a time of 19.60 seconds. Congratulations to Had to Be Ivory. Second, number 8, A Rising Miracle. Now are your total results of the sixth race from top to bottom in your programs. Number 1, Express Your Desire was sixth with a time of 20.29 seconds. 2, Country's Coming Back was a vet scratch. 3, Feisty Icon, 20.18 seconds. Delight was eighth with 8th. But ladies and gentlemen, we had a difficulty with the microphone. We will now recap the sixth race results from top to bottom in your programs. Number 1, Express Your Desire finished sixth with a time of 20.29 seconds. 2, Country's Coming Back was a vet scratch. 3, Feisty Icon finished third with a time of 20.18 seconds. 4, Sugar Man's Delight was eighth with a time of 20.53 seconds. Number five, Sweet Pagrana, finished fourth with a time of 20.18 seconds. Number six, Night Fishin', was fifth with a time of 20.27 seconds. Number seven, Albert, was seventh with a time of 20.35 seconds. Number eight, A Rising Miracle, was second with a time of 20.15 seconds. And number nine had to be Ivory, the race winner, with a time of 19.60 seconds. Rechecking from top to bottom, order of finish in your program should read 6 Vet Scratch, 384-5721. Those are the total results of the sixth race. In this upcoming seventh race, we have a couple of Vet Scratches. Scratch both from your programs, the number one horse, I'll Be Gone Flying, and number two, Hanover Hill Dashing. Also, we have a following overweight, number four, Perfect to Look At, will carry 2 pounds over. Also note, there is no show wagering or no tri-actor wagering in this upcoming seventh race. Race seven is race A of the late pick three.
A lot of frivolity and clapping and lots of joy here in the winner's circle after the Ontario, I got to get this right, Bred Maturity, or Ontario Sired, Ontario Bred Maturity, had to be Ivory, put on a show and makes us really want to see him more. We hadn't seen him since July when he had that unfortunate stumble and near miss, but boy, oh boy, that was worth the wait. I'm just going to pull this out of my ear because it just started yelling in my ear. Congratulations to the Robertson family. I'm here with trainer Bryn Robertson, his wife Carol, and jockey Tony Phillips, and also owners Jamie Robertson, and of course all the gang there, Zach Kennedy and Mike and everybody. Horse has got a big heart. Well, I was going to say he's got a big follower group.
Where's my trophy?
And Tony wants to know where his trophy is. I think it left. Tony, hello. Tell us about that. That was pretty jaw-dropping.
Well, he broke like a bat out of hell this time, I can tell you that. There was no glitches. Like, he came out on top, and he just kept going and going, and, you know, he dragged me down there. So I just kind of sat and just enjoyed the ride. I was just a pilot today. I loved it.
It's not very often you can say that in quarter horse races, because you really sort of have to get them out of the gate and, you know, get down and riding to win by a head. But that was a long margin for a quarter horse race, was it not?
Well, don't forget, it's also 400, too. I mean, you know, 400 makes a huge difference. I mean, if it was three or so, it would have been a lot tighter, but 400 makes a huge difference.
Well, congratulations, TP. That's your boy. I mean, I remember you picking him out. You said you picked him out as a foal or a young horse you wanted to ride, and the ride continues, and the big race coming up in October, the Peacock Memorial.
Well, Country Boy's also running today, so let's see how both of them do, and then we'll take it from there. But once again, if your ride ain't right, you ain't rapping tight. And if your ride ain't hype, you ain't rapping right.
All right. Give him the hook. Send him home. Bryn and Carol, congratulations. Amazing effort by this wonderful horse, and, you know, they had the one meeting, him and Country Boy, last year, and Country Boy won. But this year, your boy has matured and certainly gotten better. Track record, Bryn, did you expect that?
I thought he could run good, but I wasn't sure because he hasn't run in 2 months. He stumbled the last race and kind of tweaked himself. But we kept him going and doctored him up, and he's running better than ever.
And that was a big race, 108. Carol, it's very good to see you. We know you've had some health issues, but you made the right decision to come today, that's for sure. I think Ivory knew that you were here today.
Maybe he did.
Worth the drive to Ajax.
It's worth the drive. You could make a commercial out of that. So, Bryn, ready for one more start then, locally, the Alex P. Cobb Memorial in, I believe, October, beginning of October. What do you do between now and then?
Oh, we'll give him a couple of days off, put him on the walker, and then we'll start to gallop him easy. We'll gallop him every other day till and keep him fit, then I'll give him a breeze, and then hoping he'll be ready for the trials for the Alex Peekoff. But there's no trials, so we'll go right into the big race, and we'll hope to have him ready.
And you'll be up against your neighbor, Ruthie Barber, and Country Boy, who runs later today. Well, congratulations, guys. We'll let you go and enjoy the trophy and everything, and we'll see you again soon. Had to be Ivory has won the maturity in a big track record effort.
Tonight.